Superhuman, today we're going to be diving into this email application, giving an idea and a breakdown of some of the features and an experience that I've had over the last couple of years. I'm going to be talking about other email applications in this video and also how this application compares with them. So hopefully this will give you a judgment on whether this application is any good and whether it's right for you. So welcome everyone, my name is Francesco. If you're new here, hit subscribe. And if you did want to, we've got a brand new course called the Bento Methodology 2.0. It'll be linked below, but essentially this brand new course helps you to priority task manage, helping you to add a layer on your task management experience to give you effective and practical techniques to managing your day. And it's something that we've developed on from our first version of the course, and we've expanded on it much further. So I'm excited to announce that. That'll be linked below. So Superhuman, it is a really interesting application because it's priced quite heavily. It's $30 a month, and I think it's even increased to $45 a month. But I think that's for Teams. I'm not entirely sure. But the application itself is very much targeted at those who spend a considerable amount of time on email. I formerly used an app called Tempo, which I loved, and another app I used called Missive. Both were really, really good. I think Missive is much more suitable for those who are looking to collaborate on email and who are looking to expand with team members. I think that's pretty good setup there. But Superhuman landed on my plate probably about a year and a half ago, and I really just jumped into it. And I thought, okay, I'll do one of these onboarding experiences that they do and sort of learn how it works. And to be honest, I was very skeptical at the start, but actually I was pretty impressed. And there's a couple of features I want to talk about and show you before we begin. So I think the first thing that really makes Superhuman different to other stuff is the command bar. What's different about the command bar is when you press command K, you really do get the power of it, but you need to learn the keyboards. I'm not somebody that likes keyboard shortcuts, but once you learn these, it actually saves you a huge amount of time. Like, I'm so used to using like H to remind me, which is essentially snooze, and things like create snippets so that I can routinely create something that I'm sending over to somebody, which is really helpful. But the command bar is the sort of power of this. And to be honest, with former email applications, Tempo didn't have a mobile application to my memory. Or they did, it was not very good on iOS. Missive had one, which was fairly good, no problem with that. But I never really used email much on my mobile. But the command bar relates so well to the mobile version that you can use the command bar on mobile pretty easily. So actually I've been using email on my phone so much more than I was before and able to clear inbox items. But what's most notable is, I don't know whether you can see from this, the speed of Superhuman is very fast and it does work very smoothly. I've not had another email experience that's been this fast. Tempo was fast, but this is a different level of fast. It like loads instantaneously, and I've never had like a fault with it in terms of speed and function. More recently, I've been trying the AI functions, like just playing around with AI in email. And to be honest, I don't get on with AI in email. I think it's weird to have an email. I think it's maybe it's a generational thing that I'm just sort of in the middle with. When I'm trying to formulate an email, I only write in my own words. Whereas I think it probably is quite good if you're trying to reformat something to convey more detail and things like that. But I haven't really gone deep on the Superhuman AI, but in itself, it's probably a feature that I wouldn't use as much. But they do have a more recent AI feature that they have introduced. Other smaller things I like about Superhuman is the unsubscribe button. I quite like that. I like the ability to tab stuff. So what you can do is, when you have like a specific a topic that you are like, you're getting considerable amount of emails for, like VIP, news, other, etc., you can create a new sort of tab for it, and it reroutes your emails into there each time, which is quite nice. And the other function I do like is the ability to see your calendar in there to some extent, because it helps me to see, okay, when I type in Thursday 17th of March, it'll allow me to see the whether it is a Thursday, 17th of March, or just 17th of March. So that's quite a nice feature. Other elements I do like about it is that you can switch between multiple accounts pretty easily on Gmail, and they've added more abilities as well. And overall, the experience is really snappy and fluid. So who would I recommend Superhuman for? Now, if I wasn't handling a lot of email a day, a lot of sponsorships, I would say me 4 years ago wouldn't have needed Superhuman, because I was in a place where I was editing most of the day and I was doing elements. But now I'm not doing editing, thank you, Steve, and I'm not doing as much writing, and I'm doing much more like high level management of stuff. And having something like Superhuman with email helps me to do that. So I'm more of the customer now than I was in the past. So if you're somebody that probably sends 2 hours or more on email and you're reaching it from a high level perspective, then this could be good for you. If you're a freelancer and you're spending a hideous amount of time in email, then this could be a good investment of your money. But at the same time, is working out, are you starting out as a freelancer? Because I probably don't recommend it for you. But if you're somebody that's a bit more grounded and you've got revenue cash flow coming in, then maybe it might be a bit better for you. I would say this is much more structured for individuals that are looking to go much more hands-on with their email and faster. So I wouldn't necessarily recommend it for everyone, but they're probably the use cases I'd say are best for Superhuman. So that was my overview of it. If you're interested in asking any questions, I'll be available in the comments below. If you did want to explore more email applications that are on the internet, then you can go over to Toolfinder. My brain isn't working today, and you can naturally find some more that are there. And if you're interested, you can check out the Bento Methodology Course 2.0. Today wasn't a very good episode for my brain. It's not switched on today. But thank you very much for stopping by, and I hope this gave you an overview for Superhuman and whether it's right for you. Thank you very much, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.